Hi friends, this is Harinaganand Idumudi, English Shorthand Instructor. If you want to join in my WhatsApp group, please send a message to 970-44-55-002. Now I am going to dictate a passage at 100 words per minute. 5 seconds. Start. Keeping the aforementioned observations in mind and examining the facts of the case at hand, we are of the considered opinion that the High Court made no mistake in allowing the respondent's appeal and remanding the suit to the trial court for fresh trial on merits after affording an opportunity to the respondent's defendants to file their written statement to enable them to contest the suit on merits. It is true that the time was granted to the defendants to file written statement initially before closing their right to file written statement. Yet, in our view, the trial court, instead of closing their right to file written statement, should have granted some time to the defendants, subject to payment of reasonable amount of costs to the plaintiff to compensate the inconvenience caused to the plaintiff. The High Court was therefore right in imposing a cost of ₹11,250 on the defendants to be paid to the plaintiff as a precondition to file the written statement within the extended time granted by the High Court. In our view, here comes the application of observations of Vivian Bose when His Lordship said too technical a construction of a section that leaves no room for reasonable elasticity of interpretation should therefore be guarded against, provided always that justice is done to both parties, lest the very means designed for the furtherance of justice be used to frustrate it. Our laws of procedure are grounded on a principle of natural justice, which requires that men should not be condemned unheard, that a decision should not be reached behind their back, that proceedings that affect their lives and property should not continue in their absence, and that they should not be precluded from participating in them. Having observed this, His Lordship cautioned, of course, there must be exceptions to, and where they are clearly defined, they must be given effect to. And finally, His Lordship concluded, observing, but taken by and large and subject to that proviso, our laws of procedure should be construed wherever that is reasonable, possible in the light of that principle. The approach of the High Court, which resulted in remand of the case to the trial court for deciding the suit on merits after affording full opportunity to the defendants to contest the case and at the same time making it obligatory to pay cost of ₹11,250 to the plaintiff, was, in our view, in tune with the aforementioned observations and did substantial justice to both the parties. In view of foregoing discussion, we concur with the reasoning and the conclusion arrived at by the High Court and find no merit in the appeal. It is accordingly dismissed. We, however, find that none appeared for the respondents' defendants in this appeal, though served. The trial court will now take up the suit to its file and will issue notice of suit proceedings to the respondents defendants for their appearance in the suit. On their entering appearance pursuant to service of fresh notice, the trial court will grant them some time to deposit the cost amount fixed by the High Court and also to file their return statement. Stop.